Hey guys, Mikey Swartz here, Whiplash DVD. As you may know, my original channel had its comments disabled by YouTube and I could not turn them back on. So I decided to start two new channels. One is the new Whiplash DVD channel. The other one is the one that you're watching right now called Tacoma Apocalypse. This is where you're gonna see us put a 5.7 liter iForce V8 engine into a second gen Tacoma. We're calling this the TACUNDRA build. Leave me a comment below, let me know what you think, and make sure you subscribe to this new channel, Tacoma Apocalypse.
Hey guys, got an update video for you. Right now I'm down here in my personal garage. Got the Tundra squeezed in here. I got my key guy coming today to make a key for this thing because I want to see it run before I pull it out, just to make sure everything's good with it. Computer, wiring, all that stuff. Because if I go through all the hassle of putting it in the other truck and then it doesn't start, you know, then I'm not going to know what I'm dealing with. So I'm going to get it running in this truck first and go from there. I just want a key made so I can start it.
I need the slug though.
Okay.
Can you take that camera? Let me help you out.
He thinks the light bothers me, but it really doesn't.
Yeah. How's that come out of there?
Hammer and a screwdriver.
Well, you need to work on it a little bit.
We'll get it out of there in a jiffy.
I need to pull this lock cylinder out, but this door is really jammed shut, so we're gonna use a pry bar here, see if we can get this thing out of there. I mean, it doesn't really matter if we break it off or whatever. So let's get this door open. Bear's got Bertha over there. That's our big pry bar. Well, that looks like it should go. You got a pretty good grip on it. That's right. It's probably broke off in there and it's locked right now. That might actually work. Oh yeah, shine your light in here once. For what? Right there's the latch. There's a little access right there. Yeah. I can't see fish in that with that door there. Oh, well, okay. I see what you're saying. Don't shut that door. Actually, hold it open right now. Feels like maybe a clip.
A few moments later.
All right, guys, Constantine actually got the lock out of the door.
You should turn the flash on. I like flash.
He's going to attempt to cut us a key.
Pick that.
He's going to cut us a key.
Look at this.
High-tech locksmith.
Thank you.
We're in the van now.
That's where all the secret will be
redeveloped.
See you later.
Meanwhile,
that's it. Got it. Yeah. Well, it's. Oh, that door's holding it. Open that door. We'll try it out. Okay. All right, kids, we got the door open. Gotta power this thing up now. So. Yeah, that's it. Okay, lights off. It's got power.
To make the check the oil on the truck.
No, but I'm about to. Where is the dipstick in one of these? Hmm. Oh, here. Convenient. Looks all right. Overfilled. That's good. It's better than under. Ogre pointed out that this thing probably landed on its wheels, or else all this oil would be everywhere.
So yeah, the whole underside of the hood, usually in like the intake manifold and stuff, is normally just covered in oil.
Hey, can you see how many miles are on it right now? We still don't know how many miles are on it. I don't know if it'll pop up or if you have to get the key in it. Horn works. Nah, you have to. Okay. That was good. I was going to use that. My truck needs an antenna. Wow.
Could act like you don't got aftermarket ones at the shop.
I don't.
You do.
And that's a factory one.
Yeah.
Fucking jackass.
You know what I gotta do here? Shine the light down here. This is the thing I noticed when we picked this up. This little plug right here. That's the ECU, and that plug got broke out. So I'm gonna try to plug that back in right now because I don't know what all that does. But we might need it in there just to get the key to program. I don't know. I wonder what's holding it back. There's like no free play in that plug. I am really upset about this. It's like the worst part about this whole truck right there. That metal's pushing it away, so I'm gonna have to shove down on that. Okay?
What?
Where's Bertha?
Over here. I'm doing something right now, actually.
Oh, well, you know, I'm sure that's way more important than what I'm doing.
Well, where is Bertha? Over there? You're not using her?
Okay. This is Bertha, our shop pry bar. Shine the light down in there, and for what?
You want me to hook power up?
Yeah.
Try it now. 134,830.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, what are you doing?
It starts the truck.
How do you know that?
It's
because cranking. The key he just cut without a transponder and it's turning the engine over.
That doesn't mean it's going to start. I'm trying to get the ECU plugged in, that one plug that's broke off.
That ripped up metal there is just pushing this out too far. I see now this is a plug from the truck itself. So my engine harness is good. That's really good news. That plug could even be the same as what's in my Tacoma. I doubt it is though. I should be able to go to a junkyard and get this plug out of another truck. It's not part of the main engine harness or anything. It's part of the truck's harness. So that'll make that much easier to deal with. This thing probably runs to the gauges, like the fuel pump, the main relay, stuff like that. So I'm sure this is gonna need plugged in to make this thing start. Hopefully the pins will stay in it and hopefully I can get it plugged in.
Have you ever gonna make a key for a crashed vehicle?
Yeah.
Shine that light down in here. This is gonna be a knuckle buster. I don't think that's gonna help much. Yeah, I might need an extra hand. We need to pry the wires over a little bit. Really not thrilled about doing this, but we gotta get this plugged in. And there. Now can you get it plugged in? Be gentle with it.
Got it.
Yeah,
it's heard it click. Yeah.
Excellent. Okay, that's plugged in.
Hey, make sure we're not leaking fuel anymore, by the way.
We're good.
Should we try to fire it?
We'll see.
As soon as
he's programming the key.
Oh, gotcha.
Alright, you want me to try?
Yes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Keep going.
Maybe. Well, what's that noise?
You want me to keep going?
Yeah, go ahead, try it.
Oh, it's so close.
What?
It's close. It doesn't seem like it's getting fuel. Okay. Hearing some noise back there.
It can make it. Something's going on though.
Yeah.
I wonder if one of the fuel lines is slightly.
I'm just guessing.
Look under it. Yeah. Is that just water?
Yeah, but the key's wrong.
Sweet.
Okay. Good deal. Thanks,
sweet,
man. I don't think it's getting fuel.
Yeah.
I'll bet you it has a rollover sensor that tripped. We'll probably have to find it and then reset it.
How much you bet?
How much do you want to bet?
Well,
I'll just lie to you and tell you that's what it was anyway.
One non-transponder key.
Does that conclude our update video?
No.
No, let's see if we can get it running. I think we're going to need Google right now. Okay, let's see. Toyota Tundra
roll sensor?
Maybe?
Kelly's, we need a quiet on the set.
Quiet on the set, Kelly's. Come on. Hey! Yo, dude.
Roll sensing.
Let's try Toyota Tundra crash reset. This is gonna be hard to find. I did do this in like an 07 Civic once, and I can't remember how I made it start again. Let me try Pro Demand and see if I can find anything on there. We use Pro Demand at the shop. It's kind of like having a Haynes manual. Fuel level. Is there fuel in it?
Should be.
Ooh.
Unless the fuel tank got punctured.
Should be is not a good answer. We better check that. That fuel tank did get hit. It's hanging down. That could be it. Let's check that fuel tank.
It is pretty hurt right here.
Let me get the key on and see if there's any fuel. See what the gas gauge says. The fuel light's on and it's on E. Oh, it certainly hurt. Wow, you see that? Where the filler nut goes into it? That's broke off. Yeah, it might even be the sending unit up top. In fact, I bet you some of that stuff is ripped off.
Let me just pick it up higher. Okay, here's a filler neck. That got ripped off, and then this little breather, something with the evap. All the wires look good going to it. Well, the camera can probably see better than I can. Might just have to watch the video back to see what's going on, because I can't get up in there.
Looks like all the essential stuff is plugged in, the sending unit, like that pushes the fuel out, all the wiring's still good, but the tank is knocked loose, so the back's hanging way down. It is low on fuel too, according to the gauge. I'll bet this is full of fuel back here, but it looks like the sending unit's up here. So I'm gonna try to put something under this and drop the lift down.
This is not a professional way to do this, by the way.
Don't ever try this at home.
Stick your head down there and see if you can even hear that fuel pump. Let me bump the starter once so you can hear it.
No.
The gauge did come up now. It's up like eighth of a tank.
Nice.
So it should be able to get it now.
Try it again.
Kind of sounds like maybe the intake's off, like it's not getting a mass air reading. Let me pull it wide open.
Do you want to be famous?
Well, we didn't get as far as I wanted to today, but we did get a key made, got the immobilizer programmed, got the truck cranking, and it's actually putting a little bit, so I believe it is getting spark, but it doesn't seem to be getting fuel, and I'm gonna blame that on some kind of crash sensor, even though I really honestly don't know. So I'm looking for suggestions. What do you guys think? I know I got some solid Toyota guys watching this program, so let me know what you think. Give me your ideas, you know? The only other thing I can think of is if the fuel pump is running, maybe there's water in the gas because that filler neck was unhooked. So I'm really not sure. Let me know what you think. I do want to thank everyone for subscribing to the channel and helping me out with sharing the videos and clicking the like button and leaving the comments. I really do appreciate it. It's helping me out a lot. I can't do it without you guys. I got a big spike in subscriber count right now and it's continuing to go up and I really do appreciate it. Thank you guys. And please keep sharing the videos and clicking the like buttons and tell your friends to subscribe, you know? Thanks guys, see ya.